all. So we are going to perform the experiment for the measurement of pressure. So the name of the experiment is pressure measurement apparatus. What is the aim? So aim is by mentioning the title, you must have been understood, to measure the pressure. What the different things that we are going to do over here of horizontal and vertical pipe. So once we will just complete this, I will also make you understand how this apparatus looks like and why we are calling it horizontal and vertical pipe. But for you, as of now, to understand, we are saying horizontal pipe means this would be looks like somehow like this, and for vertical, so it would be looking like this is the vertical section, and again this is the vertical section. So our setup is I'm just here making the tube or the pipe. I'm not making the overall configuration or the overall apparatus, that I will let you make you understand over there. So this is the vertical section, this is the horizontal section, and this is again the vertical section. So basically we need to measure the point at the different we need to measure the point at different points. So let us just take this point in the vertical section, again this point in the vertical section, this point on the horizontal section, this point on the horizontal section, again this point in the vertical section, and this point in the vertical section. So basically what we need to do, we need to measure the pressure for this vertical and the horizontal pipe. But one more condition is there. When you will also see this apparatus, you will come to know about this particular thing in detail, that we are having the variable cross section. What do we mean by variable cross section? I just when the area is changing, and the area will be changing when the diameter of the tube is changing. So for the vertical section, we don't have the variable diameter of the area, but for this horizontal, we have the variable area. So this variable area means initially it would be this, your area is going to decrease, your diameter is going to decrease, then again it is it might increase, and again it might take some cross section. So this is how you can say there is a variation in the diameter which will lead to the change in the area. Although this is not exactly the same which you are going to see in the apparatus, because I could not make the overall or the overall length, the overall horizontal length. But what I'm trying to say here, that you need to measure the pressure at the different points for the different cross section. And now you understand what do we mean by the different cross sections. So we are having the variable cross section on the horizontal tube. At some point you might see the area is in diameter is decreasing, at some point it is increasing. So the aim is to measure the pressure of horizontal and the vertical tube pipe, or the pipe we are calling it as is a pipe, because it is made up of some material here. We can see it is made up of the SS. For we have taken two conditions over here. Number one is variable cross section. Variable cross section, as I already told you, for the variable area or for the variable diameter, change in the diameter. Variable means when there is a change, your cross section is not constant throughout. And for the second is the variable flow rate. Means let us just consider one flow rate, that is Q1, for this one set. Then for this Q1 we need to check all the pressure, P1, P2, P3 means P1, P2, P3 indicates the points on which you are measuring the pressure in terms of the head for all horizontal, at the horizontal and the vertical tube. So initially we will set one flow rate, let us just call this flow rate has been set up as Q1. So for this Q1 you need to measure all the pressure for vertical and the horizontal pipe for the variable cross section. Same for Q2, means change, we have also changing the flow rate. So your Q2, you may increase with respect to this Q1, or you may also decrease with respect to Q1. So whatever is the value you want to take, but you need to take a different value of Q2. So for again for this value of Q2, you need to calculate P1, P2, P3, and so on as per the number of points here. again take some different value of Q that we are mentioning here is Q3, and for this Q3 again measure all the values of P2, P3 and so on. So what we are doing? We are measuring the pressure for horizontal and vertical pipe for two cases. Number one is a variable cross section where your diameter is changing for the horizontal tube, and second is variable flow rate. But we are not going to change both the things together. We are doing it if we are measuring the pressure throughout your horizontal and vertical length, then it will be taken for only one flow rate. And in the next set we are going to change the flow rate, and in the another next set we are going to change the flow rate. Means what we are doing for one set, means for the measurement of all the pressure for together one set, P1 to PN whatsoever number we have, we are going to keep the constant flow rate, and we are again changing this flow rate for the different set of the pressure reading. So this is how which we need to do. How we are going to do that? So this will fall under the procedure. So again the procedure is very simple. Set the this is the second. Subset first is fill the tank with water. So basically we would be having a tank which I just showed to you, that at the bottom we will be having the tank, and the water will be, with the help of the pump, will be coming into this vertical and the horizontal pipe that you will come to know. So fill the tank with the water, number one. Once you have filled it, of course you need to switch on the pump so that the liquid or the water which you are taking here can travel into the pipe. Second is set the flow rate. So for whatever amount, obviously you have switch on the pump. So let us just include this switch on the pump. Switch on the pump. Let us just say this is the point number second. And point number third would be set the flow rate. So of course your pump will be driving the force corresponding to, or the driving the liquid corresponding to the horsepower, corresponding to the power which is being developed by the pump. But we don't want that highest flow rate. We need to change the flow rate. So let us just consider the lowest flow rate whichever we can set as a Q1 value, and corresponding to this Q1 value measure the pressure. So what we have done? We have filled the tank. We have switched on the pump. And then set the flow rate. So let us just say Q1 we have set up, and for this Q1 we need to measure the different pressure. So this is the next point, measure the pressure by manometer. So obviously whatever would be the change in the height corresponding to the change in the pressure at different horizontal and the vertical pipe, you would be having the manometer reading in what? In terms of, because of course now you know what is manometer. Manometer is a device which is being used for the measurement of pressure in the terms of the head. So here also we would be measuring in the terms of head, but which head? We are measuring it in the form of mmHg, because we are having the higher specific fluid as the higher specific liquid as this. We are taking mercury, so that is why we are going to obtain the reading in the form of mmHg, and then you can convert it into the meter of water, whatsoever is desired for us. But even if we are writing it in the form of mmHg, this will also suffice our need. So what we are doing? Measure the pressure at all the points. P1 at point number 1, point number 2, point number 3. What all are these points which I told you in this vertical and the horizontal cross section? We would be having the different points on which we are going to measure this. So measure all the points corresponding to this flow rate Q1, and then change it to Q2, Q3 and so on, and then measure all the sets. So this is the third step, measure the pressure by the manometer in terms of mmHg at different points for variable cross section which have been already discussed. So this is all about the pressure measurement apparatus. I will just again have a quick look as a revision that what all we have discussed here. So number one is basically the aim. So two, I will be removing all the things that I have discussed over here, so that as a quick review, nothing will be messed up. So our aim is and these points are at horizontal and vertical cross sections, and these cross sections are also variable cross section, right? How for this we need the apparatus of the pressure measurement, and how we are going to do that. So number one is fill the tank. Number two is switch on the power. Number three is switch on the power of pump, basically. Yeah, switch on the pump, we can also say switch on the pump. The moment you will be switching on the pump, liquid will start rising up. So but it is our hand to set the flow rate. So basically it is a desired flow rate, on which you want to measure the pressure. Once your flow rate is set, let us just call as Q1. And for this Q1 reading, next is measure all pressure at 1, 2, 3 corresponding to this Q1. And then repeat the procedure for different values of flow rate. Let us just call Q2 for measuring the point pressure at 1, 2. So this is only this is very simple, that we just have to measure the pressure, and the pressure will be measured in the form of MMHG, because we are having HG as a fluid in the manometer, and this can be done by the flow rate whatever we are going to maintain over here, and this can be done by switching on the pump. So this is it about this experiment. Now I am going to show you this apparatus, how does it look like. Thank you.